All right, so we now know that slightly soluble salts, formerly known as insoluble salts, actually do dissolve, but very small extent. So what kinds of questions can we ask? One thing that we can ask about is what is the molar solubility? It is useful to know how much of it would dissolve or what would be the concentrations of the ions for one of these insoluble salts if you have a solution that contains a saturated solution of it. And so what we want to look at in order to calculate what would the molar solubility be or what would the concentration of ions be, we want to look at what are the values for the equilibrium constants or the KSP values. You can find lots and lots of tables of KSP values. Let's look for some. All right, this is a table for a general chemistry class of solubility product constants, which are KSP values at 25 degrees Celsius. Recall from an earlier chapter that an equilibrium constant is only constant at constant temperature. It is organized by type of anion, fluorides, chlorides, bromides, carbonates, etc. We see that in general these are very, very small numbers, times 10 to the minus something. One thing that you might note is that the numerical value for the KSP may vary slightly depending on which table you look at. These are experimental values, and so we do often see a variety of values. Here's another table, KSP at 25 degrees Celsius. This one is organized by cations, so all the cobalts are together, the calciums are together, etc. So we see a variety of tables for solubility product constants. All right, here's a table. This looks like it was taken from a textbook. And we do see, again, a huge variety of these numerical values. Please be aware as you're doing your homework, you might want to pull up the table that comes with the homework package. On a test, these numerical values would be given to you if you needed them to answer the question. And again, be aware that different tables may list slightly different values for KSPs. Our table in our textbook is what I'm going to be using the most. So let's ask the question, what is the molar solubility of magnesium hydroxide? Magnesium hydroxide is one of the hydroxide that often gets listed as insoluble because it's only slightly soluble. And if we look up the KSP value for magnesium hydroxide in the table in our textbook, we see that it is 5.6 times 10 to the minus 12. Remember that your equilibrium constants are unitless. Also, the table in our textbook happens to go ahead and list that equilibrium reaction, but you should be able to write it. What is this the KSP for? An equilibrium constant is a constant for a particular equilibrium reaction, and the equilibrium reaction that this is the KSP for will always have the same format. It is the salt breaking up into the ions. You do have to watch your stoichiometry. In this particular case, we get two hydroxide ions for every one magnesium ion. Now, as this dissolves, and it will only slightly dissolve, you put some initial amount of solid in, you get one magnesium, two hydroxide ions. We can think of this in terms of an ice table, where initially we have some mass of this. Now, we don't actually have to keep track of the magnesium hydroxide because it does not show up in an equilibrium constant expression, but I like to keep track of it in terms of simply what's going on with it, and there is some mass of it. Initially, there is zero and zero of this. As it dissolves, X of it will dissolve into ions, and I'll get X magnesium ions and 2X hydroxide ions. So at equilibrium, I will have some amount of my solid left, which doesn't really matter, X magnesium ions and 2X hydroxide ions. So my equilibrium constant expression, which is the concentration of magnesium times the concentration of the hydroxide ion squared, don't forget about your squared, looks like this. So at equilibrium, we can calculate what the magnesium ion concentration would be. That would be X. What the hydroxide ion concentration would be, that would be 2X. Or we could calculate the molar solubility, which is how much dissolves, which is, in this case, X. almost always you're going to set up your ice table such that your molar solubility is equal to X. The ions concentrations won't always be X, depending on what the stoichiometry is, but the solubility typically is X in your equation. So I have 5.6 times 10 to the minus 12th, that is my KSP, and that's going to be equal to X times 2X squared, because 2X is my hydroxide ion concentration. And so I end up with 5.6 times 10 to the minus 12th is equal to 4X cubed, which can be solved fairly easily for X. Make sure you know where your cube root button is on your calculator. It looks like we'll go to 2 sig figs, and so X is equal to 1.1 times 10 to the minus 4. So I would report that my molar solubility is 1.1 times 10 to the minus 4 molarity. That is in moles per liter. If I need it in grams per liter or grams per milliliter or some other unit, I can change moles to grams, and that would be moles of magnesium hydroxide that dissolves. So I would use the molar mass of MgOH2 to get my solubility in grams if I needed it. And yes, you still have to know how to do that. Typically, we want it in molarity, though. We would also report that our magnesium ion concentration at equilibrium is 1.1 times 10 to the minus 4 molarity, since it is equal to X, and that our hydroxide ion concentration is 2X, so our OH minus concentration is 2.2 times 10 to the minus 4 molarity. And so any of these questions can be asked, all of them can be thought of. You can think of this in an ice table, since we're used to that, but what we see a lot in textbooks is that in working with KSP values, often the ice table is eliminated simply because it is very easy to go directly to my X's and my 2X's based on the stoichiometry. I do find drawing the ice table useful in this case, though. All right, let's look at the next way to ask the question. In the next case, we want to look at not knowing KSP, and that being what we tried to find. All right, let's say that under certain temperatures, for example, it might not be at 25 degrees Celsius, so we wouldn't be able to look up the KSP. We want to know what would the KSP, for example, for aluminum hydroxide be. In order to find the KSP, we need some experimental evidence, we need some data, and typically this is to give you what the molar solubility is. If you are told that the molar solubility at a certain temperature, for example, is 1.8 times 10 to the minus 10 molarity. It's really, really small. What is the numerical value for KSP? Again, we need to think in terms of what the molar solubility means and how we can use it to find the KSP. And so what is very useful is to go ahead and write the equilibrium reaction that this is the KSP for. They all have exactly the same format. You start with the solid, you break it up into the ions. We've been doing that since Gen Chem 1 when we first learned about solutions. You do have to watch your stoichiometry. And so as this dissolves, if we think about it in terms of an ice table, some initial mass of it, some amount will dissolve. Let's call it X. That is our molar solubility, which means we get X aluminum ions and 3X hydroxide ions because of the stoichiometry. Again, a lot of people just skip the whole ice table because it's pretty straightforward, but I find it useful to draw it. We also, I've been telling you, find it useful to go ahead and write the formula for the K, in which case I have the aluminum ion concentration and the hydroxide ion concentration cubed. Make sure you know where your cube button is. And that's what I'm trying to find. What I need is the equilibrium concentrations of aluminum ion and hydroxide ions. In other words, I need to plug these into those concentrations. Well, I know what X is. The molar solubility is my X. That is how much of it dissolves. And so my KSP is going to be equal to the aluminum is X, so 1.8 times 10 to the minus 10. The hydroxide is 3x, so 3 times 1.8 times 10 to the minus 10, and that whole thing is cubed. Be careful punching it in your calculator. Make sure you cube this whole amount after multiplying by 3, and that will solve for your equilibrium constant. And we do get a very small KSP. Our KSP, it looks like we need to go to 2 sig figs, is 2.8 times 10 to the minus 38. Remember that it's unitless. So this is the numerical value for our KSP, our solubility product constant, given the molar solubility.